Hi students, today we are going to discuss chapter 4, change in profit sharing ratio among the partners. The learning objectives in this chapter: the concept of reconstitution of partnership, meaning determination of sacrificing ratio and gaining ratio, accounting for goodwill, accounting for reserve, accumulated profit and losses, revaluation of assets and reassessment of liability, and finally preparation of new balance sheet. So, definition and meaning. First one, partnership definition. Partnership is the relation between person who have agreed to share the profit of the business carried by all or any of them acting for all. Indian Partnership Act 1932, section 4. So it's generally two or more persons joined together start a business and sharing profit and loss. The business carried on behalf of all the partners, any one take management part, or else all the partners take part in that management activities. The partnership agreement defines the term of relationship among the partners. So whenever there is a change in terms of agreement, it's a result reconstitution of firm. The agreement, the written agreement, is called partnership deed. What are all the things consist in partnership deed? You know very well: name of the partner, address, capital invested, profit sharing ratio, then interest on drawing, interest on capital. So many things that are involved in that agreement. The term, that relationship among the partners, how much capital introduced, then profit sharing ratio. These are the things very, very important. So if any changes in the terms, it is result reconstitution of firm. That means old agreement going to close, then newly one constructed or new agreement is formed. So we need to prepare accounts for new terms and conditions. Any changes in existing agreement of partnership is reconstitution of partnership firm. As a result, existing agreement comes to an end and new agreement comes to an existence. Then a firm is reconstituted in the event of, so what are the reasons they are going to reconstitute? So change in profit sharing ratio among the existing partner. So existing partner profit sharing ratio changes, or else admission of partner or partners can admit any one new partner or more than one partner admitted in the business. Then retirement of partner, any one partner relieving in that partnership firm. Then death of partner, anyone illness or else death, that time you are going to reconstitute the firm. Then amalgamation of two or more partnership firm. So existing partnership firm, more than one partnership firm joined together and form a new partnership, that is called amalgamation. These are the situation we want to reconstitute the firm. Then the changing profit sharing ratio among the existing partner. In this chapter, first one point you are going to discuss. The existing partner may agree to share the profit and loss in the ratio that is different from the earlier agreed profit sharing ratio. That means earlier one was closed, then new agreement was framed. That is called only the profit sharing ratio only changes. So it leads to dissolution of partnership and not the firm, because the existing partnership agreement end and a new agreement come into effect, but the firm will not closed anywhere. Firm is there, but only that relationship among the partners only changes. For given clear example, A, B are partners sharing profit in the ratio 2:1, that is earlier one, it was decided by them to share profit equally. So year after that, A and B want to share the profits equally, that means 50%, 50%, but before the agreement 2:1, An accounting procedure or else accounting treatment for changing profit sharing ratio among the partners. First one, we want to find out the sacrificing ratio and gaining ratio. So sacrificing means any one partner leave her existing profits some percentage to another one partner. So gaining ratio means that partner receiving some share from sacrificing partner. Sacrificing means we want to sacrifice profit to one partner and getting gain for another one partner. Then accounting for goodwill. So in last chapter 3, valuation and methods of valuation and how to distribute that goodwill to partners, you learn very well. Then accounting treatment for goodwill here needed. Then third one, accounting for reserve and accumulated profit and losses. So reserve, any undistributed reserve or accumulated profit in existing balance sheet, we want to transfer capital account. Then revaluation of assets and reassessment of liabilities. While admitting or changing profit sharing ratio, that time the asset value again they are revaluing. For example, while formation of partnership firm, they bought a building 5 crores. At present, what is the value of that building? Maybe more than 5 crores or less than 5 crores. We want to revalue the assets and reassessment of liabilities. Then adjustment of capital, we need to prepare separate capital account for all the partners. Then finally, preparing balance sheet. Then first one, determination of sacrificing and gaining ratio. So sacrificing ratio, it is the ratio in which one or more partners of the firm sacrificing their share in favor of one or more partners of the firm. So for example, A, B, C are partners. Their profit sharing ratio 1:2:3, but new profit sharing ratio is equally, that means 1:1:1. That time A profit no changes, but B profit have to sacrifice something, then gaining. So want to sacrifice something and getting profit. So C want to sacrifice something and giving to B. While doing that time you will get clarity. But sacrificing ratio equals old ratio minus new ratio. This is the formula. Then sacrificing ratio SR equaled OR minus NR. Or keep in your mind SON, S-O-N. Is an memory tips. Don't write in your notebook and examination sheet. SON, that means sacrificing ratio equals old ratio minus new ratio. Then gaining ratio, it is the ratio in which one or more partners gain profit shares as a result of sacrificed profit share by one or more partners of the firm. So it is simply one person expenses, another one person benefit. One person income, another one person is loss. Like that only. For A sacrifice and B getting profit. That's all. Then gaining ratio, what is the formula? New ratio minus old ratio. GR equals NR minus OR. This is a simple example. So A, B are partners sharing profit in the ratio 2:1. It was decided by them to share profit equally. So equally means, that means A and B equals 1:1. Now first finding that sacrificing ratio, you can find any one sacrificing ratio or else gaining ratio. Don't find both the things. So I'll explain. So sacrificing ratio equals old ratio minus new ratio. A, what is the old ratio? 2:1. 2 plus 1 3, total profit equals 3. Out of 3 A will get 2 and B will get 1. So A share of old profit 2 by 3, B share old profit 1 by 3. Then decided to share profit equally, that means 1 is to 1. So total 1 plus 1 equals 2. So new profit sharing ratio 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Now the fraction addition, so denominator is not common, so denominator multiplication 2 3s are 6, then cross multiplication 2 2s are 4, then 3 1s are 3, 4 minus 3 equals 1 by 6. So sacrificing ratio will get positive, that is 1 by 6. That means this is called sacrificing. B 1 by 3 minus 1 by 2, that means denominator 6, then 2 minus 3 minus 1 by 6. While calculating sacrificing ratio, that time you will get the answer in negative symbol, that is called gaining ratio. Clear? Or else if you are using gaining ratio formula, so new ratio minus old ratio, A equals new ratio 1 by 2, B equals 1 by 2. Then what is the old ratio? 2 by 3 and 1 by 3. So denominator 6, then 3 minus 1, 4. That means sacrificing ratio minus 1 by 6. Then B equals, what is that, gaining ratio minus 1 by 6. That time minus symbol means it is a sacrificing ratio. Then B 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3, 3 minus 2 divided by 6 equals 1 by 6 is a gaining ratio. You can utilize any one formula, that is sacrificing ratio or gaining ratio. So in your book page number 4.39, first 4 exercise. This is very very important. Based on this only you are going to treat goodwill and reserve, all the things. So if you made a minor mistake in this calculating sacrificing ratio and gaining ratio, the whole sum going to be a wrong. So while preparing, while calculating sacrificing ratio and gaining ratio, be careful and thorough and do first 4 exercise, book page number 4.39. Have a nice day. Thank you.